नमस्कार, आदाब, सत श्री अकाल। वेलकम टू माय चैनल कंटिन्यूअस लर्निंग। वी विश यू ऑल अ वेरी हैप्पी एंड प्रॉस्पेरस न्यू ईयर। सो विदाउट वेस्टिंग एनी फर्दर टाइम, लेट अस क्विकली बिगिन विद द वीडियो। इट इज कॉमनली बिलीव्ड दैट कस्टमर्स डोंट रियली नो व्हाट दे वांट, दे हैव टू बी टोल्ड। बट द ट्रूथ इज द कस्टमर्स डू नो व्हाट दे वांट, बट दे मे नॉट बी प्रोफिशिएंट इन डिस्क्राइबिंग देयर नीड्स। And by understanding the three type of need the customer has, and if we figure out how to reveal them, we better know our customers' true needs, and then we can further plan out how to address them. And you know what? Kernow analysis is one of the best tools which helps us in understanding the customer needs. This model basically involves two dimensions, achievement and satisfaction. So stay tuned to the end of the video to understand this beautiful concept of capturing customer needs and how to make sure that the customer is fully satisfied. So before we deep dive into details of Kernow model, let us have a quick overview on how the Kernow model looks like. So Kernow model basically involves two dimensions. There is a vertical dimension which starts from the bottom to the top. The bottom indicates a very dissatisfied or a very low satisfied customer, and the top indicates a very high satisfied or a super satisfied customer. However, the horizontal axis indicates the achievement which is achieved by a supplier if they execute their offerings or their commitments to a fair decent level or an excellent level, and this indicates a excellent execution. And on the extreme left you can see a poor execution or no execution. So this is an execution cum satisfaction comparison which we refer while understanding the needs of the customer, plotting it, and then ensuring customer satisfaction to its best possible manner. This was created by Professor Noriaki Kano in 1894 to classify customer preferences into three distinct categories, which you can see in the video. The three categories are performance, basic, and excitement characteristic. He discovered that these different attributes have different impact on the customer satisfaction when one, they are fulfilled, and two, they are unfulfilled. And this model applies to a variety of areas like product, services, business processes, and software development, etc. So let us understand what does these three characteristics mean. So performance are basically the requirements that the customers are able to articulate and are at top of their mind. So if they are, you know, not fulfilled, the customers would be very dissatisfied. And if they are fulfilled, the customers would be highly satisfied. And this is something customers would freely talk about. In the later part of the video, we'll understand with some examples what does this mean. The second most important category comes to be the basic category, the basic requirement, and this is also termed as the must be requirement. These are the requirements that the customers expect and they take it for granted. When this is completed, then customers would not be super satisfied. Their satisfaction level would be neutral because this is a basic requirement, right? But if they are not fulfilled, then the customers may become super dissatisfied, right? And they are the requirements that must be included and up and are the price of entry into a market, right? The third category is excitement. So these are the unexpected and the pleasant surprises that we provide to our customers. We also term that as USPs or the unique selling propositions. Some of the users call it as a wow factor. You know, they delight the customers when they are in our products. Customers would feel a wow factor. But if they are missing, then the customers would not be highly dissatisfied because customer never expected this for the first place, right? So this is something we are offering to the customers to make them feel quite delighted. So these are the key three aspects where we map customers' requirement to make sure that we address them properly. So let us move ahead in the video and understand more about Kernow analysis. So Kernow analysis basically is a framework to analyze customer need or customer needs. It helps in understanding how a product or service fits customer needs. Third, it helps categorizing and prioritizing the different features of a product or service based on their impact to the customer satisfaction. And those categories are then further considered when analyzing potential opportunities for improvement, right? So now let us discuss more about Kernow analysis. So as discussed earlier in the video, this model involves two dimensions, the vertical dimension, which is the satisfaction, and the horizontal dimension, which is the achievement. So the vertical dimension indicates on the bottom side, it indicates an unsatisfied customer, and the top part indicates the satisfied customer. On the horizontal axis, the extreme left side indicates the poor execution and the extreme right side indicates the excellent execution. So this is how it now looks like. So this is a comparison between satisfaction versus execution, right? So the first part we discussed was about satisfiers. So these are basically linked to customer satisfaction. If provided, the customer would be satisfied, but if it isn't, then the customer would be dissatisfied. They are not absolutely necessary, but they result in satisfaction when fulfilled. The more you provide, the more the customer is satisfied. For example, the speed of answering a phone in a call center, or maybe the reduced amount of spoilage on a production line. So let us move to the second characteristic or the second attribute, which are the delighters. So if you can see the green curve, it indicates the delighters. So if you know they are those wow factors or the features which I provide to the customer to make sure that the customer is super satisfied and differentiate me from my competitive suppliers, is something which comes into this kind of needs. For example, I check into a hotel and the hotel team provides me, you know, with a bottle of wine or maybe a group or a bunch of flowers. So this is something I did not expect, but if the opposite person provides us, then I would feel highly delighted. So this is something which is termed as delighters. They are unspoken needs, but when they are fulfilled, then the customer is super delighted. So now let us discuss about the next category, which is the must be category. But these are basically unspoken needs of a customer, you know. So, and these are something which the customer takes for granted. For example, a defect free product, right? For example, I buy a car and I expect the brakes and the windshield to be a part of the car, right? So if they are present, then I would not be super delighted, but my satisfaction level would be normal. But if they are absent, then I would be super dissatisfied. So we learned about three categories: the must be needs, the performance need, and the third one is the delighters. So these are the three basic kind of factors which are into the Kano analysis, where we figure out the execution or the degree of achievement versus customer satisfaction, and we plot our needs and understand that which of our features lie into which category, and then we further plan accordingly. So this is how the Kano model looks like, the way we discussed earlier in the video. So we have three factors. One is the delighters, which are the unspoken needs. If absent, the customer would not be dissatisfied, would be neutral, but if present, the customer would be super satisfied. In terms of satisfier, these are the revealed or the spoken needs. If absent, the customer would be super unsatisfied. If present, the customer would be satisfied. And the third one are the must be and the unspoken needs. It is directly linked with customer satisfaction. If present, then customer would be normal in satisfaction, would not be super satisfied. But if absent, the customer would be super unsatisfied. So this is how we understand or interpret the Kano model. So a Kano analysis basically involves five main type of features. The three we discussed, that is the must be feature, the performance features, and the excitement features. There are two other features as well: the indifferent features and the reverse feature. So let us understand a little bit more in detail with example about these five type of features. So as discussed, the first type of feature is the must be attributes. So these are the basic criteria and a reasonable level of quality, and the customers take it for granted. If they are not present, customer would be dissatisfied. If they are present, customer will not bring any, you know, this will not bring any additional satisfaction to the customers. Examples: the timely and response customer service, a defect free product, the brake and windshield of the car, the way I discussed earlier in the video. The second attribute was performance attribute. So they are not absolutely necessary, right? They result in satisfaction when fulfilled and dissatisfaction when not fulfilled. The more you provide, the more the customer is satisfied. Examples: the speed of answering a phone in a call center, right? So the more quickly we answer, the more customer satisfaction it brings. The reduced amount of spoilage on a production line or in a production line, and the warranty period and the fuel consumption of a car. So these are examples of certain features which may result in satisfaction when fulfilled and dissatisfaction when not fulfilled, right? Next comes the delighters category. The organization should aim for giving customers more than what they expect. This is what differentiates them from their competitive suppliers. They distinguish our products and our services, and they are mostly unexpected and unspoken, and they are provided to the customers with no extra money. That is the reason they are termed as delighters. Example, a basket of fruit after having booked a room in a hotel, a bottle of wine, or a welcome or an expensive welcome kit during joining a particular organization. So this is something which we do not pay for, but if we receive, we are extremely delighted. Then comes the next category, the indifferent attributes. You can see a horizontal line. So this means that these are the attributes whose presence or absence does not bring satisfaction to the customer. Even if they are present, still the customer would be the satisfaction would be at the same level, and if they are absent, still the satisfaction would be at the same level. Examples are those product features that are never or very rarely used by a customer. So even if a very rarely used feature is not present, the customer would not be that much dissatisfied. And even if it is present, then the customer may or may not be dissatisfied, right? The last one is the reverse attributes. They are those whose presence brings dissatisfaction. So they are termed as reverse attributes. So some customers prefer high-tech products while others prefer a basic model of the product like a cell phone. Some people prefer using a high-end technical, high-specified or specification cell phone, but the others may be very satisfied with a basic feature phone, right? And providing them with too much of additional features may dissatisfy them. So these kind of attributes may be termed into reverse attributes, and their presence may bring dissatisfaction to the customer. So now let us understand, how do we use the Kanno model? Number one, with our team, we brainstorm all the features that we have in a product or we wish to have in a product. Then we brainstorm everything that I can do to excite or satisfy my customer. Then we classify all the features as either basic or satisfier or delighter or indifferent, reverse or not relevant. Then we cut out all the indifferent and non-relevant attributes because they will not lead into customer satisfaction, and we may waste a lot of energy and time and cost while providing these features. Then we make sure that the product has all appropriate basic features. This is the must requirement. And then we select the right performance features so that the product can be delivered at a price at which the customer is ready to pay. And then finally, we think, how can we build in some delighters into a product? So we follow these steps, and then we make sure that the product we are offering to the customer fulfills all the basic needs, does not have indifferent or non-relevant attributes, has a lot of maybe some delighters, and then we offer this feature at a very good price to the customer, which the customer would happily pay for. So let us quickly have a look at the tips before we wind up this video. So the Kanno model highlights how the customer requirements are constantly changing. Today's delighters may become tomorrow's must-be requirement, and this requires us to constantly come up with new delighters. For example, earlier the schools with air conditioners used to be a wow factor, right? Maybe 10, 12 years or maybe 15 years from now. But now this has become a must-be requirement. You will find every alternate school having an air conditioner. And going forward, the same applies for the hotels as well, right? Earlier, there used to be a different category with air conditioner, without air conditioner, but now this has become a must-be requirement. So a delighter yesterday has become today's must-be. So we, constantly need to come up with new delighters to make sure we provide immense customer satisfaction. Third, this analysis does not present methods to be applied to carry out improvement activities. And the final point, the result of applying the Kanno model can be used in quality function deployment, that is QFD matrix, to clarify relationship between customer needs and technical requirements, right? So this was all about the Kanno analysis. We understood about the basic attributes, which focus on identifying the type of needs a customer has, or we are offering the feature to the customer. We'll identify our offerings to the customer in different categories or the different attributes, and we'll see which are the must required attributes and which are the features we can cut upon so that we offer the best product to the customers at a price which they are ready to pay us for. So this is it for today's video, guys. Thank you for your time and thank you for watching. I believe you all would have understood the concept of Kano analysis. It is a very beautiful concept, and you can use this concept to ensure immense customer satisfaction, which would differentiate you from your competitive suppliers. If you do find the content meaningful, do not forget to like the video and subscribe to my channel. Also, do not forget to hit the bell icon to stay tuned to the latest updates on the channel. Feel free to share the video with your friends. You may also follow us on Instagram and Facebook. We will be back again with another video. Till then, bye-bye.